Hi, I'm John, and in this ittaster video, I'm going to show you how to install and configure DHCP with Windows Server 2012. Now, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, or DHCP, enables us to automatically assign IP addresses and additional network configuration settings to our client devices. This is something that's essential when working with larger networks, because manually assigning IP addresses becomes difficult to manage and ultimately unworkable. DHCP solves the problem. Okay, before we start, I'll quickly show you how our server is set up. Our server is called Server 1. It's a domain controller in the domain ittaster.local, and I've given it a fixed IP address of 10.0.0.2. The first thing we need to do is install DHCP, and to do that we need to click Manage, click Add Roles and Features. This screen just tells us what the Add Roles and Features wizard does, and we can just click Next. We need to go for a role-based or feature-based installation, and click Next. We need to select the destination server from our server pool that we want to install the DHCP role on. I've just the one server, Server 1, and click Next. We need to tick the DHCP server box. We need to add features that are required for DHCP. Now, you'll notice in the upper right hand corner the wizard reminds us which server the role has been installed on, which is really useful when working with multiple servers. And click Next. On the Select Features screen, we simply need to click Next. This screen basically tells us what DHCP does, and it also tells us our server must have a static IP address. It also recommends we plan our DHCP config, document it, and keep it in a safe place, which is sound advice. And click Next. We need to confirm our selections and click Install. Okay, I've speeded things up there a little, and we need to click Close to complete. Now, we've got a notification at the top of the screen, and if we click on it, it tells us we have a post-deployment configuration task. We need to click Complete DHCP Configuration so we can configure the DHCP server. This screen tells us these security groups will be created for delegation, and authorize the DHCP server on this target computer to prevent rogue DHCP servers. Click Next. We need to specify the account credentials to authorize this DHCP server. I'm going to stick with the ittaster domain administrator account. We have the option to skip authorization if we wish. Now, remember, only Active Directory authorized DHCP servers can provide IP addresses to client devices in the domain. And click Commit. This screen gives us a post-install summary, and we can click Close. I'm going to reboot the server, and then we'll continue with the configuration. The server's rebooted and I've logged back in, and we need to go to Tools, click DHCP to open the DHCP snap-in, just maximize that, and if we expand the DHCP server, Server 1, we have a couple of green ticks showing us the DHCP server is authorized and up and running. The next thing we need to do is configure a DHCP scope. This is the range of IP addresses that will be assigned to our client devices. Now, I'm going to be working with IP version 4 in this video. So to create a new DHCP scope, we need to expand IP version 4, click it, right click it, and choose New Scope. Click Next. We need to give the scope a name. I'm simply going to call it DHCP scope. And click Next.
Here we need to specify the start IP address and the end IP address in our range. Now my server has an IP address of 10.0.0.2 and a subnet mask of 255.0.0.0. So I'm going to specify a range beginning at 10.0.2.1 and ending at 10.0.2.254. And I'm going to specify a subnet mask of 255.0.0.0, which has been added automatically for us. And click Next. We can also exclude IP addresses in the DHCP scope to prevent them from being issued to client devices. Now this can come in handy if you have devices such as network printers or manage switches with static IP addresses and you don't want them to conflict with addresses being assigned to your client devices through DHCP. So for an example, I'm going to exclude the first 10 IP addresses in our address range. So I'm going to enter 10.0.2.1 to 10.0.2.10. Click Add and click Next. Here we're able to specify an IP address lease duration. This is the amount of time a client device is able to use the IP address assigned by the DHCP server before it must reapply to use it. Now the recommendation is to specify a lease duration based on the average time a computer is connected to the network. I'm going to stick with the default of 8 days and click Next. I'm going to configure DHCP options afterwards, so I'm going to choose No and click Next. This screen tells us that before clients can receive addresses, we need to add any scope specific options and we need to activate the scope. And to close the wizard, we need to click Finish. Our scope is now created, however, the red arrow indicates our scope hasn't been activated yet. Now if we expand the scope and click on Address Pool, we can see the address pool we configured, 10.0.2.1 to 10.0.2.254. And we can also see our excluded address range as well of 10.0.2.1 to 10.0.2.10. The next thing we need to configure are the scope options. Scope options are additional configuration settings we can assign to our client devices. To do this, we need to click Scope Options, right click Scope Options and choose Configure Options. I'm going to specify a DNS server to issue to our client devices. So we select number 6, enter the IP address of our DNS server, which is 10.0.0.2, and click Add. We need to wait while DNS validation takes place to establish if the DNS server service is running on the server we specified. I'm going to specify the DNS domain name, which is number 15, and our domain name is ittaster.local. And finally, I'm going to specify a default gateway. And we need to go back to number 3 and choose router. And I'm going to enter a default gateway of 10.0.0.1. Click Add. And click Apply. And there are the scope options that will be assigned to client devices. The last thing we need to do is to activate the scope. And to do this, we need to right click the scope and click Activate. And if we click IP version 4, we can see that our scope is now active. Okay, let's switch to a client workstation so we can test the DHCP server. I've logged on to a Windows 8 client workstation, and if we go to a command prompt and type ipconfig/all and take a look at the details. First, we can see the DHCP server that assigned us the address, which is 10.0.0.2, our ittaster domain controller. There's our IP address that we've been assigned of 10.0.2.11. And if you remember, we excluded the first 10 IP addresses in our range. There's our subnet mask of 255.0.0.0. There are the lease details. We can also see the DNS server that we specified in our server options, and also our default gateway. Okay, let's go back to the server because there's one thing I want to show you. If we click on address leases, we can see our workstation, workstation 1. We can see the IP address leased, and we can also see when the lease expires.
Well, I hope this video has been helpful. Please give your support and subscribe to the IT Taster channel. Comments are welcome, and thanks very much for watching.